Jack, are you there?
Oh, hey, Pops. What are you doing here?
Stop calling me Pops. Anyway, I have a message for you.
A message? From who?
From Lady Ridley. She's having a birthday party at the castle tomorrow. She wants you to come too. That's what she said, at least.
You mean, Ridley's feeling better?
Yup, she's right as rain again.
Wow, that's great news. But,
what is it?
Why did she invite me?
I don't know. All I know is she asked me to ask you. Anyway, make sure you come, okay?
For sure. Hey, wait! I'm not a knight anymore. They won't let me into the castle.
Not a problem. Don't worry about it. Here, just show this to the guards. It's an invitation from Lady Ridley. Now make sure you show up. Do you hear, Jack? I've got to go.
A birthday party, huh? Well, I don't have much choice. I mean, she did ask me and all. It's kind of a pain, but I guess I have to go. Radiata Castle. It hasn't been that long since I left. Feels like ages ago, though. Hi, Mr. Guardman. I've got one of these.
Okay, go on in.
Hi. Hi.
Ridley. There she is. Hey, look at you. Back on your feet. I knew you were just faking it.
Jack, you came.
Yep.
I'm sorry about what happened.
Huh?
You being fired from the Knights, it was my fault.
You're still worried about that? Hey, it was really no big deal. I mean, if you ask me, the Knights are kind of uptight. Peter Vancoor is more my style, you know?
I'm glad. Listen, Jack. I need to talk to you.
Ridley! Oh, him. You're Jack, right?
What are you doing here?
Huh?
Disgraced former members of the Knights usually aren't allowed in the castle, are they?
Cross, what are you saying? He's here because I invited him.
It's okay. Forget it, Ridley. Listen, I've got to be heading back home.
Jack, don't pay any attention to this idiot.
Ouch. You tell him, Ridley. You're starting to sound like your old self again.
Jack.
If you ever want to talk, stop by my place anytime, okay? See ya.
What do you think you're doing, Cross? Jack was one of my guests.
Now, is that any way for you to talk to your future husband?
I don't care what our parents think they've decided. I want nothing to do with you. Now buzz off. Ridley. Genius.
Hey, how much further do we have to go?
Almost there.
Genius, why did you bring me here?
Something I have to tell you. Something terrible. Lord Nogueira is dead.
He can't be.
He's been entombed here. That cocoon you see holds Lord Nogueira's dead body.
Where are we?
This is the graveyard of the elves. It's a place in which the fates of elves and humans are deeply entwined.
The graveyard? The elves?
Like the elf king of old. My brother lies dead, but why? That ancient king brought the human female and child to that benighted castle. And there the dark elves were born, along with Elgindars. For the first time, that terrible disease exposed the immortal elves to death. No one was immune. Even the king himself fell victim to it. It infected and killed him. Now it returns to claim my own flesh and blood. When our bodies decay and fall away because of disease or age, elves do not die. The transpiration lets our spirits fly to different bodies, where they can mingle with other souls. But the cursed Elgindars shuts our souls deep, deep within these cocoons. My brother, why did you perform the transpiration on that human girl? To break the natural laws that separate elf and human. Argandar's was your inevitable reward. Brother, why in the world did you bring this fate upon yourself?
Was this because of me?
Human filth. How much will you make us suffer before you are satisfied? Will you take and destroy everything we have? Will you continue to spread the plague to every land in the world? Why were humans sent to try us so? Why, my brother?
Did Lord Nogueira die because of me?
I honestly don't know, but I can tell you one thing. Listen to what Zane is saying, and it's obvious. There's a long and tragic history between humans and the other races of the world. We need to find some answers, and find them soon. Time is running out. I know. There must be something I can do to help.
You can help?
I'm sorry. I had to show you this. But you needed to know what happened. You're the only human who's ever received a transpiritation.